Hi, kids. I have something for our Bible lesson today that you're probably familiar with. It's Play-Doh. I used to love playing with Play-Doh, and I know you do too. How would you describe this to somebody that wasn't familiar with it? I'd say it's soft and squishy and smooth, that you can shape it into all sorts of things. You can make a ball, you can make a heart like I did, you can make pizza that you serve to your friends, all sorts of fun things that you can do with Play-Doh. And the Bible doesn't talk about Play-Doh, but it does mention something that's very similar, and that's clay. Clay was something that people back in Bible times would have been very familiar with because it was used to make pots and bowls and water jugs and all sorts of things that they used every day. And this is what it says in Isaiah 64:8. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father, we are the clay, you are the potter, we are the work of your hand. Let's talk about what that means. In the Bible, there's a prophet named Jeremiah, and Jeremiah, you can read about Jeremiah in the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah was a prophet, and God asked him one day to go to the potter's house. So he went to the potter's house to see what was happening there. The potter was getting ready to make something, so he reached down into this kind of dark, stinky pit, and he brought out this chunk of clay, and he threw it down just like that, and it was all misshapen. It had lumps and bumps and all sorts of weird blemishes, and Jeremiah wondered what was going to happen to this. But as he watched the potter work, and the potter put it onto the wheel, and the wheel started to spin, the potter dipped his hands into water and started to shape it into something. And as he was doing that, he gently applied pressure and started shaping it into something so that the lumps could be worked out and everything would become smooth. And he kept working and he kept working. And the first time he did it, maybe it didn't work out the way he did. So the potter would start over again, and he kept shaping it and kept turning it and kept working in it. You see, the potter had a plan for the piece of clay. When he looked at the imperfect piece that he'd started with, that lumpy, bumpy lump of clay there, he didn't see all the lumps and bumps. He saw what he wanted to create, and he knew what he had to do to get it to be a beautiful vessel like this. And a vessel is something like a container that carries things. While Jeremiah was watching, he saw that imperfect lump turn into something beautiful. And that's exactly what God is doing with us. We are the clay that God wants to form into something beautiful. Instead of God comparing us to something that's already finished, like a bowl, he compares us to clay. And he wants us, because he's always changing us, he's always trying to shape us, just like clay needs to be shaped. He wants us to be more like Jesus. So he does things and allows things to happen in our lives that help shape us into the person he needs us to be so that we can better serve him. And he keeps shaping us with things that are happening around us. He's always teaching us. Sometimes he disciplines us. He challenges us with different things. Sometimes he even allows things that we don't understand to happen in our lives. And he uses all those things to help make us into something beautiful that can better serve him. Now, unlike clay that can't argue or talk, we have free will and we can do what we would like to do. But if we let God shape us and keep molding us into something beautiful and wonderful, we can be used by God to serve him and serve others, which is what I want to do in my life, and I hope you do too. Do you think God ever gets finished with us? Well, I don't think he does. I know how old I am, and I know he's still working on me, and he's still shaping me. And the things he had me do 10 or 15 years ago aren't the things he might need me to do in the future. So he keeps working on me. He keeps having me grow and change and keeps working the lumps and bumps out so I can be the most beautiful servant and serve the Lord in the most beautiful ways. So let's do this. Let's remember that when bad things happen, that God is using those things to help shape us into something beautiful because he wants the very best for us. And he can use good things and bad things to do that. It would be great if good things were the only things that happened to us, but he wouldn't be able to work us into something beautiful if it was only good all the time. The bad things teach us things too. But he always loves us and he wants the very best for us. I want you to remember that as we're going through this kind of tough time right now, that God is with us and he wants to shape us into something beautiful. He's going to use this time to do that if you'll let him, but you need to let him. So you remember that? Let's go to him now in prayer. Dear God, thank you so much for always shaping me and changing me. Please be with me always and keep my heart open to that. Thank you for being with us this week and keeping us safe. We love you and praise your name. Amen. Bye, kids. I love you and I miss you so much, and I hope to see you soon.